It's Sybil Wilkes with What You Need to Know. Today is Tuesday, June 29, 2021. Number one, before she made history as the first black woman to represent the state of Missouri in the U.S. Congress, Cori Bush was a nurse specializing in mental health. The racial and social justice activist is putting her experience to work in a new bill regarding policing and public safety. First term St. Louis Congresswoman Cori Bush is the lead sponsor of the People's Response Act that calls for the establishment of a division on community safety. It includes answering the call for non-police as first responders for emergency situations stemming from mental health issues, substance abuse, or other health complications. Number two, as efforts to introduce a federal voting rights law stall on Capitol Hill, officials at the Justice Department announced it is suing the state of Georgia over its new restrictive voting law. Attorney General Merrick Garland and the Justice Department allege that the new laws in Georgia are intentionally discriminatory. The Justice Department appears confident that it can prove the lawmakers in Georgia purposefully aim to weaken the voting powers of African American voters. Number three, two federal judges have blocked the release of debt relief payments to black, brown, and other farmers of color. Temporary injunctions on the debt subsidies have been implemented in recent weeks after lawsuits from white farmers in Florida and Wisconsin claim that the funding is racially discriminatory. Black farmers received just 0.1% of the pandemic relief slated for farmers under the Trump administration. African-American farmers in America have lost more than 12 million acres of farmland over the past century. Number four, track and field athlete Gwen Berry is no stranger to competition nor in standing up for herself. The 32-year-old African-American finished third in the hammer throw in the weekend Olympic trials, securing a place on the U.S. team headed to Tokyo. During the medal ceremony, Berry turned away from the flag to face the stands while the Star-Spangled Banner played. Many conservative Republican Donald Trump supporters lined up to attack the African-American woman's nonviolent protest against systemic racism. Number five, the current valuation for wine stands at $300 billion globally, making it a very investable asset class. Due to the unique nature of investment-grade wine, it's tracked by the London International Vintners Exchange, or LIV. However, for some reason, the primary investment market has not yet reached African-American consumers, who collectively have $1.4 trillion in spending power. I'll drink to that. Here's your daily inspiration from Yogi's Jewels. Free yourself from the guilt of the past. Join me today live on YouTube and Facebook at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Central with J. Anthony Brown as we discuss today's top headlines and more. Thank you to our What You Need to Know partner, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated. To subscribe to my free daily newsletter, please visit SybilWilkes.com. Be informed, be empowered.